You talk also about when Rajiv Gandhi decided to actually go ahead with reversing the Shah Bano judgment despite advice he had got to the contrary, that there's always been in Indian politics, and this includes the Congress, a very odd way of defining secularism in Indian politics. And that actually perhaps is what led also to Prime Minister Modi's popularity, or what you talked about, and how to make the majority community feel victimized, because they felt that they were left out otherwise in mainstream politics. How do you actually see that?
I have a slightly controversial theory about this. I believe that the vote that Rajiv Gandhi got in 1984-85, the greatest landslide anybody has got, was partly vote for change, partly sympathy vote. But I also believe it was a Hindu vote. Now in our airbrushing and rewriting of history, we forget how Sikh militants targeted Hindus, how many people were assassinated, how many massacres there were. Now, I'm not taking sides in this, but I mean, a massacre is bad. And there was a huge, huge amount of Hindu resentment. Therefore, the attack on the Golden Temple, which I opposed at the time and still oppose because I think it was a disaster, was widely welcomed in India. It was hugely popular. Then, when Mrs. Gandhi was assassinated by Sikhs and there were riots and the public emotion was stoked up, it, I think, further stoked up a sense of Hindus will not be trifled with. I think many people in the Congress, including Arun Nehru, who was probably Rajiv's advisor at that time, thought that this was a good chance for the Congress to get rid of this claim that it had a Muslim vote bank and to go for the Hindu vote. And if you look at the things Arun Nehru did, including opening the gates of the Babri Masjid and reviving that dispute, he did it quite cleverly. There was a plan to make sure that the Congress had a Hindu vote bank. The plan failed because Rajiv Gandhi had no interest in Hindu vote banks or whatever. He was still brought up in that old Indira Gandhi era of secularism. Mm. So when the Babri Masjid thing happened, he was taken by surprise, didn't know how to handle it. He didn't realize till too late. Bajaj Habibullah, who was in the PMO, has written about this, how Arun Nehru did the decision without Rajiv knowing. When the whole Shah Bano thing happened, and the Congress has always been, let's be honest, surrounded by all kinds of Sarkari Muslims who don't care that much about their community and care much more about their own advancement. They went to him and said, it's a great injustice done to Muslims, etc. He reversed it, which he should not have done. And in the case of the satanic verses, which I read about in quite great detail, I think the whole thing was very, very badly handled. Nobody in the government read the book before they banned it. And the second part of it is because the Congress abandoned the Hindu vote, it was there for the taking. Advani first tried to take it and grew the BJP from nowhere to nothing. By the time this Hindu backlash had built up, Mr. Modi came along and weaponized it.